There has been a, I'm not sure if it's a loan, I'll make sure I'm in the light here, or a gift, but anyway, we've received an Olympus XA, there we are, in its presentation box from a friend of a friend of mine who, unfortunately, whose father passed away and who was a bit of a camera keener when it comes to cameras. And would love to try it out because everyone talks about what an amazing little camera this is and how much they love it. And apparently fantastic for street photography as well as a number of other things. You know, nice little rangefinder Olympus, super compact, 35 millimeter. And this one is, I don't even know if it's ever been used. But it's old. What I'm going to attempt to do today, I've never done this before, but what I'm going to attempt to do today is pull apart this XA and change the seals. So we bought a set of XA foam seals off of eBay, and they're laser cut and apparently exactly the right size. And the gentleman who sold them to me gave me a bit of a, you know, I mean, a sort of a cheat sheet in terms of what to do, and suggested that basically what you do is you scrape off the old foam from the inside of the camera, and then just put the new seals in using a pair of tweezers. And so, he suggested you use water. I'm going to try and use isopropyl alcohol, although I did a little test, and it doesn't seem to be melting the adhesive as much as I might like. But I'm not really interested in using anything more potent than that because I don't want to be splashing it around on gears or that sort of thing, and removing some of the lubrication that's already hopefully still in the camera and working. So so here's a little how-to on taking apart the XA a little bit and clearing all the schmutz out. What you'll need is, I guess, some isopropyl alcohol, your foam seal kit, a knife, pair of tweezers, cotton swabs and toothpicks, some paper towels, and a little bit of elbow grease along with a Phillips screwdriver. So there are 5 screws to take off of the bottom. Much better. 5 screws to take off on the bottom. You can see them. 3 are long, 2 are short. And you need to make sure you put them back in the right spot. So the first one comes off just at the end. And if you open up the self-timer battery check switch, there's another one underneath. That one comes out. One beside the battery door. Where are we here? Like that. Those are the 3 long ones, and the 2 short ones are towards the end here. So by the tripod mounting plate and at the far end of the base. Now, the other thing, of course, you have to do is remove the battery door. There aren't any batteries in this camera, and if there were, I'd definitely be taking them out. And so, and then the base just sort of, it's kind of in there, and you need to, close that for a sec. You need to sort of open the shutter a little bit and just kind of sort of needs a bit of persuasion to come off. And then you have this beautiful, it's actually really quite something, all the machinery in there, hopefully working properly. And anyway, we're working on the door. So lens closed, and that is loose once the base comes off, so be very careful. And so we pop open the door, and at the far end of the door, there's a little chrome piece and a little arrow, which I think is kind of fun. And you want to open the door a little bit, grab a pair of pliers, hold on to the pin that's there, and just move it down a little tiny bit. And then holding on to everything very gently, pull the pin out, and off comes the door. Now, let me move those guys out of the way. Now, you don't need to see me sitting here digging away on the foam, but I'll show you where the foam seals go. They're all in the back door here. There are 4 of them, one on the top, one on the bottom, one on one side, and one on the other side. And the foam has disintegrated to the point where there's almost nothing left, and you can actually just even just peel it off with your fingers. Anyway, so what you want to do is you want to get all the old schmutz off as much as possible, and then you want to install the new foam, which has an adhesive backing on it that you peel off, and then we'll have a nice light tight camera. So we have cleaned all of the goo off of the back of the camera. All 4 seals go on the back. And cleaned all of the residual goo off of the camera itself. And now it's time to install the seals. So we have 4 seals, 4 little tiny pieces of foam. Kind of hard to work with. A pair of tweezers is very helpful. And you'll notice, well, I don't know if you can see, but anyway, one is longer than the other, and one of the thin edges is longer than the other. And you can see on the back of the camera, that there's basically the long one goes along the bottom and the shorter one goes along the top. And then this little piece here goes along that end there, and this little piece here with the notch lines up on that end of the door with the notch. So first one to do is the one with the notch, and it's just a matter of peeling the backing off the foam. Peel the backing off. Whoops. Is there a... And you get a grand total of one try to put this on. So what we want to do is we want to just have it down. Aha. Oops, come on you. There we go, pair of tweezers. And we're going to drop it in so that the notch and the foam line up. I'm going to hold it in place on one end and make sure it's nice and smooth and drop it in like that. And then the other side, this is either going to go one of two ways. Either it's going to be really easy or it's going to get totally messed up. So I guess we'll find out. Okay, peel it back off. Don't need that in the camera. Making sure, of course, you don't want to have these pieces of paper flying around because invariably they end up getting stuck in the worst possible spot. And it just needs to go in. Okay. Boy, that's a challenge. There we go. And then with a little flathead screwdriver, there we go. Ah, very nice. That would be, this guy needs to be, it's turning around a little bit. That's better. In you go. That guy, I think, is in there. And now the long one goes on the bottom, and the short one goes on the top. Long one. Through a screwdriver, tucking it in. Don't let it climb the edge, just on the back all the way along. And as they say, this is a bit of a challenge because the film pressure plate is in the way, and I was looking to see if there was a way that I could take the pressure plate off, and it appears that there is, but I didn't want to bend anything in doing so. It's just a matter of being patient and a matter of being lucky. And then once it's in, just tucking it in, because it'll stick. And of course, once you actually close the film back, the film door, then it'll really get seated properly. And then this one actually appears to be a bit long, so we'll just cut it so it doesn't. There you go. So it doesn't interact too much with. Now, as they say in many disassembly videos. The install is the reverse of the uninstall, so we'll just put the back on like that. Make sure it's in nice and tight. Yeah, it feels pretty good. Just like that. That, I'm pretty sure, is going to be light tight. And then we'll install the base of the camera, which, as I recall, required a little bit of fiddling. There we go. No, nope, not quite. These things are, you have to remember as well, it's 30-year-old plastic or more. So it's probably not I mean, it's actually high quality plastic, but it probably is not the most, currently not the most robust. And then we drop in a few screws. And there it is. And we'll be ready to shoot. So next video, or one of our next videos, of course, will be a actual field test with our Olympus camera back from getting our foam seals replaced. And I also have an OM4, which has exactly the same needs. And so I don't know if we'll do a video on that, but we'll have to replace all the foam, of course. And I did this one first because I was a bit worried as to whether or not I could actually get it figured out properly. So I'm glad I did. At least it would appear that I've done it. And the only way we'll really know is once we put a roll of film through and see whether or not it's fogged. But I'm fairly confident that we should be in good form. So, Olympus XA, back from, at least now, it's possible this camera won't work for some other reason, but certainly the foam seals have been replaced and the camera is ready to accept a roll of film. So there you have it. It was a bit ham-handed. I'm sure that after a couple of tries, you get a lot better at it. Good luck. That's all I can say. All I can say is be patient and be careful. And it shouldn't have a problem. So thanks for watching.